morning. Good afternoon. Manchester, New Hampshire. And all the surrounding areas. We have a hot looking lady over here, Paula Clark.
Clark. Right? Yep.
Oh, I got it right.
Right.
And then we have a nice, respectable gentleman. Do I use the word loosely or just. Reverend Eric Jackson.
You got it right.
Oh, my God.
Nice.
I got two right.
Nice.
Oh, my God. That's why I have a co-host. See? Okay. And Reverend Jackson is the minister at the Brookside Church.
Got it right again.
Yeah.
Wow.
When I plan to have my big psychic event, it's going to be one of the biggest events. And we're going to be promoting it like today, tomorrow. Because I have the feeling we're going to be. The Spirit keeps leading me there. And the one thing I know, and I'm sure you're not so annoying, if you don't listen to the Spirit, you get in big trouble.
Well, that's right.
Okay. Want to tell us a little bit about yourself?
Well, I grew up in the Bronx in New York City. I was born there, and I was born down in the village, actually, Greenwich Village. And then I spent most a lot of my life up in the Bronx. And then after that, I went to school. I went to college in New York, and then I went to seminary and studied at Drew Theological School in Madison, New Jersey. And then after that, I went and working on my Doctor of Ministry at Hartford Seminary. And then during this time, during my ministerial journey, I've served the First Calvary Baptist Church for 7 years. I've served the Smith Memorial Church in Hillsboro. And now I'm serving as the pastor at Brookside Church.
How do you like it?
Love it. They are a remarkable, remarkable congregation with many, many gifts. We have a thriving and wonderful thrift shop that serves the community at Brookside Church, and we're delighted to be able to do that because we're able to be able to provide for those who are in need.
And then the hours for that is?
So the hours for that are Wednesday and Wednesday. They're open 9 to 1 on Friday, Wednesday and Thursday 1 to 4.
And where is it located?
It's located at 2013 Elm Street, right at Brookside Church.
Now that's the upper class, isn't it?
I don't know about that. I would just say that that's Manchester.
That one. Oh, okay. But what if I told you I see you transferring to another church in about 2 more years?
I don't see that right now.
Because you have a restless spirit.
Well, I don't see myself. But I came to
the opportunity is going to be there. Let's put it that way.
Opportunities coming. Opportunities come and go. But you have to know where God has called you.
Oh yeah, that's what I'm saying. Yeah. Don't be surprised if God says that you're going to be going to. So you start to flounder in churches and you build them up to get good. Congregational people coming. Because you have the word, you have a powerful voice.
Thank you.
But you also have a word of caring. You agree with that?
Yes, I do.
I love your aura.
Thank you. Love yours too, Norm. Yeah. But
and
you
if
know,
I didn't like it, believe me, I'd
you wouldn't have me on the show.
This is why I had the show.
I love this, really do love this congregation and the direction that it's going in. This year, we had more people in worship on Easter than last year. And we're getting ready to plan a baby shower for our collaboration with the International Institute of New England to be able to serve our immigrant and refugee brothers and sisters who have children at the age of 0 through 5. That's going to be taking place on May the 6th. So there are so many exciting things that are happening at Brookside Church, which make me say, well, you know what? There's no other place where I want to be.
I don't know why, but I don't know. Do you feel the energy in here?
Yes. Nice.
You have great energy.
Thank you.
And the thing that I like about it is you're sincere with it.
Yeah.
That nothing falls. I've met a lot of ministers who, believe me, I was a born-again Christian, and they would condemn me to hell. And in fact, I love your energy, and I'm going to go visit your church. That's how much
I like
your energy.
Thank you. We love to see you. We have worship on Sundays at 10 o'clock a.m., 2013 Elm Street.
10 o'clock? Oh, that's in the morning.
That's right.
It takes me 3 hours to get my makeup on first.
Well, Sundays.
I have to get up earlier.
That's right. Earlier on Sundays at 10 a.m.
And I love your secretary there, Andrea,
yes.
Yeah, what a beautiful voice.
Well, thank you. I'm sure she'd appreciate that.
I told her that. I also think she should be singing more.
Okay.
And but I just love the energy that you have. Now, you're also executive. Okay, you're also the executive director of the
president.
President of the NAACP.
Executive director means you get a check.
Oh.
I don't get no check. Okay. I'm just the president.
You want to go tell the other guy to come on in? Oh, he's right here. Put up a chair, sit right over there, young man.
The president of the Greater Manchester NAACP.
How did you get involved?
I got involved when I came to Manchester. When I first moved to New Hampshire, I lived in a small town called Hillsborough, New Hampshire. And I decided to...
I know Hillsborough.
Yes, I decided to... I saw there was an NAACP chapter, and it would be a way for me to serve the community. And so I just decided to start hanging out with them. We did events together. I would table with them, and then I was chair of the Legal Redress Committee.
Hold on. I hate to interrupt. Yeah. Eric, could you move that way a little bit?
Which one?
This way. This way?
Joins me.
We're both there.
Okay.
Yeah.
You want that up?
Microphone yeah. up there.
Yeah, now we're all set.
All right.
Okay.
I had the best care. No, you got to put it up close to it.
So I became the president. So then they said, you know, the nominating committee asked me to serve as the president.
And you enjoy it.
I enjoy serving as president of the NAACP.
I considered that what happened in Claremont, I had to agree with you. That was such an outrage.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? I could not believe that in this state that something like that would happen to a minor. What was he, 13, 14?
Yes, he is. A very young man, very, very young.
Yeah, well, that would have been funny, wouldn't it? Yeah, but I have to agree, and I was out. People, you know, and that's like with the homeless. What can we, as members of the city, do to help our homeless?
I think it's advocating for people who are struggling, who are homeless, advocating for them that policies are put in place that will be able to provide support for them, provide support for them. I think it's also in the random acts of kindness that we show to people who are homeless, thinking about ways to support them. And if we have any friends or family or people that we trust and know that are homeless, to be able to open our doors for them. I think it's also recognizing that not everybody who's homeless means that necessarily they are that they've done something wrong.
No,
there are many times and many instances where people who are struggling, who fall, who just have circumstances in life that are cast upon them, where they just can't do any better, or things just fall apart. I'll never forget the time that I actually met someone, who was homeless and he was living on the street, and you know he had a PhD. Was a college professor, so one thing led to another. He was no longer serving in his job anymore. Couldn't find work anywhere else because of the limited number of positions available to him at the time, and he wound up homeless. So homelessness and poverty is something that can happen to anybody.
I was homeless, as I just told you. Mm-hmm. Okay, I mean I had an apartment. I was supposed to be there, just by the miracle of the higher power that I call the universal spirit. Mm-hmm. I was able to get an apartment. The day that the sheriff was going to come in and take me out of the apartment, I went in with my dog. I was able to get an apartment.
Wow.
But people, you know, and yeah, there are a lot of people that are homeless, but a lot of them choose to be homeless. I'm not saying no. No misunderstand that. But, you know, and there are a lot of programs out there that can help the homeless. I don't know if the homeless people are aware of it, but I know the government has put lots of funding towards VA homeless and all these other homeless people. And we used to have workers that would go out and work with them. I had people that are homeless that actually, and I love it, and I'm not bragging about it. I'm not trying to pat myself on the back, even though I am a great angel, you know. No, I only kid around that. But I actually had people that come to my house and we feed them. And then, you know, we send them on their merry way. You know, because isn't that what we're supposed to do? Didn't Jesus do that?
Yep, that's what we're supposed to be doing.
I couldn't live with myself. Could you?
No, absolutely not.
Could you?
No, not at all.
Oh, you want to say hi to everybody first?
Hi, everybody.
And you are who?
How you doing, sir?
Hey, good to meet you.
Good to meet you. My name's Eric.
Yeah. Eric, I'm Eric, too.
Yeah.
Nice to meet you.
He was a submarine man.
No.
No?
No, I was a firefighter who got hurt on submarine, but I...
Yes. Okay,
I was in the Navy, though, but I was never on submarines.
Yeah, oh, okay.
Okay.
But the one thing that, you know... And the diversified here, we got to come together more, not with anger, but with love.
That's right.
You know, if everybody looks at each other And I'm actually, by the way, I'm pulling it off and off of Facebook. I'm blocking everything that's negative in any political thing because I was getting too carried away with all the negative energy. And I said, wait a minute, this isn't what I'm all about. I'm about, you know, positive angel, positive working like you are, you know. Do I have my views? Do I have my opinions? I'm trying to, you know, we're all human.
Right.
I think we are, you know. You know. But the one thing that I like, when you help someone, you don't brag about it.
Right.
You help a lot of people, but you're very monk. You know what I'm saying?
Are you talking about me?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. When you brag, you don't brag about how. Okay, thank you. You will, you don't want that pat out of, oh, look how wonderful you are, you know? I don't need it either, even though
I mean, the other ways to get attention, you know, I can perform, you know, you can be a performer, you can be a dancer, you can be a singer, there's all sorts of ways to get attention.
You don't want
to
see me dancing, trust me.
The needs of people are nothing to make light of, nor is it something that you use for personal self-gain.
Yeah. You know, and I found when I used to look at that, I have to say, Reverend, I should call you Reverend Eric, right? Reverend.
Excellent,
you
were,
no, you earned the title Reverend, okay? Out of respect.
Oh, thank you.
Okay. I used to say, oh, look at me, look how wonderful I'm doing. I'm helping. She came to my house and I gave her dinner and I gave you this and that. I was looking for my own gratification, but I never found that peace that I was looking for. Until I lost everything.
Wow.
And sometimes we have to, you know? And when you lose everything, I have more appreciation for what I have today. I'm a great partner. We've been together 21 years. Not her. She's just a new partner.
I'm just a taggle.
Got it.
I just walked in the studio.
Scott's my partner. We've been together 21 years.
Wow.
I've been sober 22, and he's been, you know. It's amazing how the spirit works.
Yeah.
I'm telling you, if you're not leaving the church, you plan on doing a lot of traveling then.
I'm trying to travel less and stay home more, you know, be on the ground more. I'm trying to do less of all that. Less travel.
Don't you, you know what? The spirit says, you know, you can try what you want, but I have a lot of things. You have a lot of, believe me, when I tell you this, please, that you have a lot of places you're going to be going.
I'm trying to X off things so I can. I got a whole list. I'm trying to X off things.
I mean, I think that he will get called to different places, and that's okay. Even though your plan is to...
to stay right here, in the city of Manchester, and be even more settled.
I love Manchester.
Mm-hmm.
I don't care about all the fighting that's going on. I've been here next month 30 years. I could never picture myself living somewhere else.
Yeah, it's a beautiful, beautiful city, and the city I've always desired to live in. It's not too congested. I can go see the pastoral scenery and appreciate nature, but at the same time, I can if I just want to walk somewhere, I can do that here. All the things that I want in the city, I find here in Manchester, and I really do. You know, and one of the things I think is a true treasure in Manchester, you know, is my congregation that I love so much
and
so dearly.
You. And it's not
they've shown that to me.
Yeah, okay. And you appreciate it.
Yeah.
Because you've had to break down a lot of walls in different places you've been.
Well, yeah. But like,
what is that, Jericho, breaking down the Jericho walls or whatever, you know. But I also, they do. Now, when I talk to Andrea and the respect that she had for you, you know, it's just tremendous. She's also a very modest person, isn't she?
Well, you have to ask her about that.
I did.
She's gifted, and we appreciate having her on staff at the church.
Yeah. And, you know, and I just love talking with her. I hope she's watching, because to you too, darling, you know.
Oh, well, we're going to have to let her know, definitely, that she has to watch the show today, because you gave her a big shout-out.
Right, and it'll be replayed again Sunday at 4.
But she just came to our staff, not even, it's been November.
Really?
Yeah, since November, she's been on staff at Brookside, and it's only been about December, January, February, March, April, probably about 6 months now, and she has just fell into the role and has done such a fantastic job as our church administrator.
I think she is an awesome lady.
Oh, yeah.
I'm one of these people that I'm not bashful about what I say. I'm a triple Leo, so you know we're not bashful. But you're not married right now, right?
No.
Are you ready to be?
Well, one of the days I hope to be.
Well, I believe it's going to happen.
Good. Well, thank you.
I better get a wedding invitation too.
All right. Well, I will. Because you said that, that means you have no choice but to give you an invitation.
Right. Isn't that right? That's right. I actually see it's not that far away.
Oh, well, thank you.
You know? Oh, and she's about, like, maybe 10 years younger than you are.
Oh, Lord. I don't know.
She's going to have little kitties afterwards.
I don't know about that.
How old are you?
I'm in my 30s.
Oh, so you're young. Mm-hmm. You're a young whippersnapper compared to me. I'm only 35 with a 45-year-old son. I said that one time. Remember, and this guy says to me, "You have a 45-year-old son, and you're only 35?
Yeah.
And I looked at him, and I said, it was like the miracle of all conceptions, you know? And he really believed. I said, no, it's just a thing I have said on my show many times. And I didn't realize you have to be very careful what you say. Mm-hmm. You know, there's another lady that wears the dark glasses there, the hat, that's on this show, on your show, Inside Story.
Sandra Hicks.
Is that her name? She had to walk.
Sandra Hicks.
I love her.
Yes.
Her personality is so beautiful.
Let me tell you about, you know, if you don't know about Sandra. Sandra, when Martin Luther King Jr. Day became a holiday in the state of New Hampshire, Sandra Hicks was the very first recipient of the Martin Luther King, of the award for Martin Luther King Jr. Day in New Hampshire. She was when they had the big celebration. She was the first one to get the award.
How awesome!
From the coalition. Yep. Yeah.
I think she has the greatest personality. She always comes in here with a smile. Never know what hat she's going to wear. That's what I love about her.
Yeah.
You know. Okay. Okay. Are you ready? We're going to do a trivia question. You can't answer it, though.
I can't. Okay, got it.
Because we're on the show.
Okay.
Okay. Whenever you're ready there.
Okay, those two actors behind you, name the two actors and what movie they were in. What's that movie right there that they were in, and the two actors?
Okay.
And I'm going to show the people at home, too.
Okay. You know who they are, and you can't answer it. If you know who they are, just smile.
Yeah, your mics are up, so don't say who you think it is. Yeah.
I know one of them. I don't know. Oh, yeah, I know.
And that was a very famous movie from the 90s right there.
This movie, and whoever first caller then calls in to get this question right will get a free 10-minute reading. So, the name of the movie, the year, and the actors.
They don't need to name the year. That could be bonus. Just the name of the movie and those two actors.
Yeah. Come on. I bet somebody out there knows it. We've had people call in that know the questions. Yeah, you were on the last time we had the first trivia question.
Yes.
Yeah. And it's fun because you may mention how many people will call in on that. It's a good way to get attention.
Mm-hmm.
You know? And I kind of like the name. You like the name of the show better?
I do.
Yeah.
I do. I really like it.
You know, because this is what I want. It is community. And I want to give back to the community. I don't think you can ever give enough back to the community. You know, because they were there when I needed help. When I was at the shelter getting food to take home, there's one lady, I'll always remember, her name was Teresa or Terry. And she had these pair of moccasins. And she walked over and she handed them to me. And I said, oh my God, because I need a new pair. And I just started crying. She said, they're just a pair of shoes. You know, I still have them hidden in my closet and a memento.
Wow. And whatever happened to her?
She passed away with cancer.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
Yeah. And this is a moment we're going to, Father, when you reach in prayer for all the people that need help today, from the sickness and for people who have passed away, would you say a brief prayer for us?
Sure.
Okay.
All right. Let us all pray. God of grace and glory, we offer a prayer right now for those who are struggling, for those who have lost loved ones, and for those who are going through the very storms of life. We pray that you will touch them right now in a very special way, that you will bring about deliverance and give them hope. We also pray that those around them will have the heart and the courage to comfort them and to show your light of love to them. We pray for our country and our community, that our community and our country will remember those who are the least of them and those who are without. In your name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Thank you.
You're welcome.
We always try to send out messages to the people who are less. I get these big long lists. I keep getting to bring them in, you know. See, that's why I have a co-host, you know. Yeah. And we keep remembering, you know, because I have so many people that will call me and say this one. So the way, so what? Like you just said, that was beautiful. Thank you.
Thank you.
Do you plan on, are you traveling anywhere? Are you got any big events going on at your church?
Right now, like I said, one of the big events that's getting ready to happen is the baby shower on May the 6th in partnership with the International Institute of New England. And that's going to be to support families and children ages 0 through 5. And our church is working very, very hard on that project. So that's one of the big things that's coming up. Then also on Sunday, June the 4th is Children's Sunday. So that's at 10 a.m. Yes, 10 a.m. You got to get up out of bed a little bit early that day. 10 a.m. Sunday is going to be June 4th, Children's Sunday. And it's a chance to see our children lead worship and to share their gifts with the congregation, the community. Then on June the 10th is Music Sunday at Brookside. So we celebrate the many gifts of our choir, and the service will have a lot of good festive music to inspire us. And then I can keep going on and on, but I have one more. Yeah. And that May 20th Sunday at 4:00 p.m. We're going to have ice cream, and then we're going to have Brookside Bronze and Brass. It's a celebration, and so you'll have brass, you'll hear Brookside's choir, and I'll hear our handbell choir. It's going to be fantastic. You don't want to miss it. It's going to be ice cream syrup afterwards from Puritan. It's going to be delicious, and it's going to be a fantastic and festive time.
This is so awesome. You work with the community.
That's our goal.
That is so awesome. You don't hear it.
And that's why one of the things I was very excited about being at Brookside is that I feel like all of the things that I really feel called to do and all of the church told me that they feel called to do really is in alignment with one another. So that's been that's what makes this call at Brookside so exciting for me.
How many parishioners do you have? You used a big word.
You did.
Yeah.
He did. I would say we have about 280 on the rolls as active members, and then we also have about 113 that are inactive members, and then we have a cadre of friends of the church who may worship, but they're not necessarily covenant members.
Yeah. Okay. But I actually see you growing. You really are. You know what I have found, that people are looking for answers. You know, because our country's being destroyed. The earth, you know, in all over the world, people are being destroyed, and people are looking for answers. Yeah. When they get them through your church, when they get them through us or whomever, you know, people are getting to, well, what's the reason? What are we doing? See, I'm a firm believer, I'm a messenger from Nostradamus. Mm-hmm. And it also says in Revelation that man, you know, will destroy themselves. And now we got to try to reverse that and make it so that man will love themselves and love each other.
And that's so important. I think that's where faith communities can be. One way faith communities, that's why they're so important, because when you attend a faith community, you know, like Brookside, you know, it's a place that welcomes and celebrates and upholds that principle of God's love, yeah, where all people can come together no matter who they are or where they are on life's journey and be welcomed, which is a lot different than what we're seeing in the world today.
Yeah. I've got to find a message, because they got two things I got to talk about in a little while. About there's a Narcane training session in, I got to look it all up, in Massachusetts, and then there's another place that's opening up, Infinity Life or something. I have to look it up to make an announcement. Because people, the one thing I have noticed, that a lot more people are starting to become community involved.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and this is the only way we're going to make New Hampshire, the world, you know, everything better, is by working together.
Right.
You know, and we don't, my favorite, I like doing it, going to people and say, hi, how are you doing, or good morning, and you get to grumpy with it, and I'll say, I'm sorry, you having a bad day or something. Sometimes that just little, hi, how are you? that can make a big difference.
Smile goes a long way.
Yeah. And I will also, and I think that more people, instead of giving them money, take them to, like, you know, those street vendors they had that sell hot dogs and hamburgers and stuff like that. Take them over and buy them. And don't give them the money. Give them the food. Because if you give them the money, they're going to spend on gosh, well, you know, well, I mean, it's their choice, but I'd rather buy food in their bellies, you know. And we got to, instead of the politicians trying to hide the homes, it's here. We got to get together, maybe have a group meeting and get together. Well, you're going to be on Facebook, by the way, with us.
Okay.
Okay.
What's happening on Facebook?
Well, I take all the pictures, okay, then I download them on the Facebook, and I also put them on YouTube.
Okay.
I'll let you know so you can follow through with it if you want.
Okay? Great, great.
You know. Because I'm not I love publicity. I'm an entertainer. If I don't have that publicity, then what am I here for?
You know? So tell me about that. You're entertainer. What have you? Tell me about your background in entertainment.
Oh, my background is being a psychic.
Okay.
Okay. being a class clown.
That's how it starts.
You can never tell that, right?
No.
And actually, I love going on stage.
Okay.
Okay. I do psychic readings on stage. I'm a comedian when I do it. I'm kind of like a dirty old psychic. They tell me at times. But I've been doing this entertainment. I've been on this show now, but a different name, but for 18 years.
Okay.
And I love it. I love going to the parties. I love entertainment. I love doing the psychic event. We got a big one coming up. You're going to be there, I'm sure. You know, you're
going to mark it out.
But I just love the entertainment of helping other people. That's my entertainment. I love going on stage. And they asked me not to sing. Thanks, my son will call and dad don't sing, you know.
All right, so you don't sing. Okay.
No, I don't sing. Oh, no. You'll be running out the door.
You play any instruments?
No.
Okay.
I have no ketone and no nothing. I just go. I used to, when I first wanted to go to college, I was a dancer. I'm not going to go into details, but, you know. And worked my way to college. And I have no guilt for it.
Okay.
If I did it, why would I have done it, right?
Gotta do what you gotta do, right?
Yeah, you do what you gotta do to go to school, you know? And I
mean, what'd you study?
Nursing.
Nursing. And you study here in New Hampshire?
No, California.
California, okay, wow. Yeah, so you've come a long way.
Yeah. Let's be honest, in New Hampshire, they would have never accepted my kind of dancing. They put him me out of the town or whatever. No, and I wanted to go to school. Everybody called me a moron. Everybody, I got name called, feeble minded, and all that. And I went to the principal. I was dressed in drag, you know what that is, right? You understand what I mean? And I went to the principal and I said, how do you like me now? And I've shown him my diploma from college. And he goes, I don't remember. I said, of course not. You don't want to remember me. And I was all dressed up with a blonde hair and all that thing. And I went over to one of the queen of the prom. And I said, oh my, have we got a little hefty these days since you graduated from college? He goes, like that. I showed him. He goes, well. Then they all remembered who I was. Of course, the spirit has a way of paying karma back. I fell into the swimming pool with bleached blonde hair. Don't ever do that because your hair should have turned bright.
That's right. Yeah. Green. Chemicals.
Yeah.
Chemicals in
but
the water.
But then I do a lot of, right now I do a lot of spiritual counseling.
Mm-hmm.
I help other people. I get a lot of people complimenting me for it. And I think that's great. And then again, I don't want to pack up. This is what I do for entertainment. Like you're on the pulpit, you're preaching. That's entertainment.
Mm-hmm.
Because you put a lot of showism into it, right? Okay, well,
there is a line. It's this one.
There you go.
Gorham's Community Corner, you're on the air. Hello.
Just give it a second.
Okay. Hi.
Hi.
Hi, this is Kathy.
Hi, Kathy.
How are you, Norman?
I am doing really well. How about you, darling?
Not bad. I have actually some questions, if I may.
Sure.
I have a grandbaby coming. What do you think you said with her pregnancy?
What'd she say?
I think she said you had a grandbaby coming.
Oh, your grandchild's going to come out loud mouth like his grandmother.
And everything, how is it?
And everything's going to be fine. You're going to have the grandchild's going to be A-okay.
Awesome. Do you know what it is?
It's going to be a boy.
Boy. Okay, one other question. Do you see me moving soon?
I'm looking at by the end of the summer.
By the end of the summer.
Yeah, don't rush it.
No, I was looking to get out of here thought you said by May.
Well, I'm looking more towards the end of the summer because there's some problems there. Well, you can move in May if you want, but I want you to find a place that's comfortable for you.
Will do.
Okay.
Everything else is okay?
Everything else is fine. Everything else, you're going to be around for a long time. Your mom and dad both say hi.
Awesome. Have a good afternoon.
You
Thank
too.
Thank you so much.
Okay, bye-bye now.
Bye-bye.
Yeah. See, that's what I like doing. I like reassuring people. That's what I do on the phone, doing the readings and all that. And I can remember I went to this Born Again Christian church, and my daughter went 36 hours. And then she said to me, because I was such a bad person, that God took her away from me.
Oh, no.
Oh, yeah. And, of course, I tried to commit.
That's awful, to tell someone that. And said, that's terrible.
And so I said that's Christianity. I don't want any part of it. You know? But with you, I would feel very comfortable going to your church.
Wow.
Because you do make people, and you don't judge.
No, that's not, I don't think, because I don't, I never saw, you know, Jesus trying to harm others or trying to hurt people, but Jesus, it came with a message of love, and that's what, you know, and because Jesus' love was so wide, I believe that's why they killed him in the end.
Oh, I agree. Mm-hmm. I agree. You know, and, but that, ever since then, man, I've had a hard time with it. I hid all my sorrows and alcohol.
Mm-hmm.
I've always known I've been a spiritual person. I don't even like the word psychic, but spiritual person.
Yeah.
I've always known I've done that ever since I was a child and all that. And I kept, the more people condemn me for it, the more alcohol I drank.
Mm.
Oh, yeah. And then I became a nurse. And then one day I left nursing because I was afraid I'd give them the bad shot or whatever. And then that's when I lost everything to have everything. That makes sense?
Yes, it does.
Okay. Sometimes we have to lose everything to end up having everything. You know? And I also see you getting a new car.
Well, I just got one recently, but...
brand new one?
Well, I had no choice because mine got totaled. Uh-huh. Someone backed into me, and it was a freak accident that happened, actually, at the gas station in Concord. They hit the car just right. Well, I wouldn't say just right, but they hit the car in a way where it destroyed the switch on my hood. And next thing you know, you're out on the road and flapped up. Yeah. So the car was done.
Yeah. Well, how do you like the one you got?
I like it. It's all right. It's all right.
It gets you where you gotta go.
Gets me where I gotta go. Point A to point B. Yeah. But hey, you know, I won't say no to a new car.
I was a convertible person.
Okay, you like convertibles?
Oh yeah, gotta get my hair flowing in there, you know.
Do you drive one now?
No, I went blind for I was totally blind for like 7 years.
Wow.
And I needed that lesson. You know, I really did, and I know this now. I know how people are made fun of. You know, I went to Dunkin' Donuts one time. They had a coffee. The lady thought it was cute to stick the white cane and kick it down the hallway. So I had to go find it. You know, and now I truly know that, and now I have a better understanding of what a handicapped person is like.
Yeah.
Okay. Sometimes we need to go that way.
Yep. Because, you know, and I think it's out of moments like that that we truly start to understand who we are and then in our relationship to God and to the world. Is, you know, unfortunately, it's through those experiences that help to shape, evolve, and develop us.
See, when they come to my office, I don't pull it even. They can't pull it on me because I've been there. And, you know, and like with you, you've been there. You know that, you know, when they try to give you a bunch of booby, you know, and all that. And I'll tell I've been there. When I was drinking, my days of drinking, I used to go to the church and then give me money to buy more alcohol, although I wouldn't tell the truth. But then I got a conscience. I had to pay it all back. Sometimes conscience will get you going.
No.
Okay. So how long have you been a minister, though?
I've been a minister now for over 10 years. Let's see. It's probably been total, doing the math. Haven't really done the math in a while. Let's see. Probably about 12, 13 years now.
Your parents are proud of you?
Oh, yes. Incredibly. My family's very supportive.
That's the best part. Mm-hmm. And when your family supports you, whatever you do.
Right.
You know. Got a call coming in.
Oh, okay. There you go. All right.
Norm's Community Corner. You're on the air.
I'll take the calls.
Okay, she'll take them.
Mike, that bad.
Yeah. Okay, he'll let us direct, which is good.
So he's going to direct the call here?
Yeah, usually he'll pick him up. You still call right directly, but we'll let him call it for us. Because when we're talking,
I just flunked phone answering.
Yeah. one of the I've seen with you is, are your family in the ministry as well?
We have a couple family members that are.
How do you know that God led you to do this?
Because there's you can't shake it off. There's nothing, you know. Every road kept leading back to ministry. You know, you can't shake it, and you know it's the voice of God that's directing you and calling you.
Oh, isn't that awful? And I kept saying, you're going to do it, you're going to do it. You know, right. That's like, I've always known I've been a spiritualist, and I kept putting it on the shelf, like with you, right? We always know.
You know, I'll work easily 12, 13 hours a day. And no matter how tired I am, I still just can't see myself doing anything else. I love being a pastor. I love caring for my congregation. And I love being a leader in God's church and making a difference in the community and hopefully the world one day. So, you know, so that's, you know, so I'm so happy with what I do. So that's another thing that affirms that call for me is that I love being a pastor. I love what I do.
Community, welcome to Knowing Community Corner.
Hey. Hi there, how you doing?
Good, how are you, Mary?
Sadly to say that, you know Beverly.
Yeah.
Yeah, my friend, her son passed away this morning.
Oh no, I'm so sorry to hear that. Okay. Yeah. Was he sick for a long time?
No, not that long, believe it or not, maybe a year.
Wow, you know.
Yeah.
Well, you offer our condolences from us and from Reverend Jackson, too.
Yeah,
our condolences.
I met Reverend. I think it was in January when they were over at St. George's on Martin Luther King. I learned a lot that day that, you know, negativity were around you. But, you know, I'm glad I went to it. I really learned a lot that day that he had it.
Oh wow! Well, I'm so glad that you came that day. We had a good time at the celebration, and it really was a celebration.
Yeah, it was good. I learned a lot. I really did. I learned a lot that day.
So you know we're going to be having it next year. We're hoping to see you back again next year.
Yeah, well, I'll be there. Yeah. This is truly what Mary said. Yeah. I invited you, and whenever you have time to come on my show.
This Mary LeMay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Cruising with Mary.
All right.
Yeah.
She's my troublemaker, you know.
All right.
She was my I've known Mary for many, many years. She was like my bodyguard.
Yep.
Wow.
I started a fight, she'd finish him for me.
Small world, I said.
Yeah. Now she has her own show.
I ended up finishing it.
Yeah.
Yes. Well, Mary, I left you a message on your voicemail, and I'm hoping to hear back from you, and we can set up a date for me. I would love to come on your show.
Alrighty, thank you.
Oh, Mary, you didn't know it, but you're in charge of the food committee on our next event, by the way.
Okay, that sounds good to me.
We're going to be having it at Reverend Jackson's church.
Oh, you're going to like it there.
Yeah, oh, I know.
I've been there quite a few times with different things. Yeah.
Well, the spirit keeps pushing me.
And it's really a nice place. Yeah.
Well, you know, the funny part, like I first had a Unitarian Universalist church, mm-hmm. We outgrew that church. And it kept pushing me to go there first. And I go, no.
How many people do you get at these events?
We get close to 200 or 300 people to go through.
Wow.
We have a lot of people. Last year for the Manchester, we raised, 1,800 or 2,000 in Manchester Animal Shelter, Mary? You know, in one day. You know? And this is what we're doing for the charity for the Healing Paws. Like, what we do, if you have a cat or a dog and you can't afford to take care of, you know, the animal care for it, if they're sick or whatever, we'll pay for it.
Oh, wow.
The only thing we won't pay for is the neutering of the rabies, because you get those free anyway, you know. Mm-hmm. And, like, if you want to have him neutered, we'll pay for that, too.
You know? No, I'm not in charge of that.
But that's our goal, is to make it merry. Mary, this Sunday we're going to be having another meeting. If you're up to it, you're more than welcome to come.
Alrighty, it sounds good. I'm just waiting for her to contact me, so find out, you know, when the funeral and everything else is going to go on.
Well, I'm glad you were able to call and tell us about it. Beverly is a lady that can out-talk all three of us at one time.
Really? Who's Beverly?
And she's a very good friend of Mary. I love her dearly. She's a very good
friend. Is she from Manchester? She's local.
Where is she? Merrimack, right?
Yeah, she's in Merrimack now,
And she's a sweetie. She really is. And boy, she can talk. She can talk all of us out. And I thought I could talk, and I can. See, that's one thing.
Yeah, they're great people.
Yeah. One thing that I did with my shyness was become an entertainer like I'm doing now. I used to hide behind a refrigerator. That's how shy I used to be as a kid growing
up. Wow. Yeah, yeah. How'd you overcome that shyness?
By starting believing in me.
All right. But how'd that happen? Because naturally you don't just start
believing
yourself.
It took a lot of years.
Yeah, it takes a lot to build self-confidence.
I got tired of hiding in the alcohol.
Okay.
I was always doing readings. I was always doing the negative readings and all that. But then in order to get confident, I had a very good friend of mine, and bless his heart, his name was Leonard Burgess, said, you got to learn how to be more confident in you. And actually, even as a nurse, I was still very shy. And like that. But then when I started walking and saying, oh my God, what have I done? Where am I going? And what's happening with my life? And all of a sudden he showed me that message. It's a long walk from Derry, New Hampshire to Manchester. You know, especially at 11 o'clock at night and the wind is cold. Oh. But I needed it. And that's when I started really building up. And I'd say, you know what? This is what I got to do. And it took a lot of years. And there are times when I still want to hide away. But, you know, you can have confidence if you want to. It's all up to you. Look at you. You had confidence, right?
Well, yeah, try to keep it up, you know. That's but for me, it's not so much about confidence as it is being able to speak my truth and being able to speak up.
Yeah. Well, Mary, I'm going to thank you for the call because we got another one coming through.
Alrighty.
Yeah. Call me at home. Yeah. Bye bye now. Yeah.
Bye bye.
Yeah. Good job.
So good far.
Good job. were you shy?
Oh yeah. But the thing is, as a child, my mother would put me in fashion shows. Halloween costume parties and stuff. So, or you know, when she took me to work with her, she would teach me how to introduce myself to people. And okay, this is what you do, this is how you shake hands. And so she helped to build that confidence in me as a young child. But then as I grew up and started entering into ministry a little bit more, I had a good mentor who would always encourage me at meetings to speak up. And she always encouraged me that I have something valuable. We all have something valuable at this table to contribute. So before I would sit in the meeting, I wouldn't say anything. I'd be quiet as church mouse. Mm-hmm. But, you know, she would stop the meeting and she would say, Eric, you didn't talk. And she would do it every meeting until the point where I just naturally just started talking at meetings.
And then you can't shut up now, right? Me too. I was 4 years old when I said my first word.
Wow.
And I was four and a half when I did my first step. And, you know, I guess they said I had polio or something like that, you know.
Okay.
And I had these most wonderful foster parents that helped me to walk, helped me to talk, helped me to do things. As far as I don't know when it is that I had real parents. But you know what? That's okay today. I had a foster mother. If mothers were like my foster mother, I had the best foster mother in the world, you know. And you don't have to be a blood parent, a blood relative to be a good parent.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. You know, and I always felt like I was invading on her privacy until one day Spirit came through and said, no, you didn't. She welcomed you there. So, you know. And ever since my mother said, now that you know how to talk, you would never shut up. But, you know. Are you an artist as well?
No, I cannot paint. I cannot.
Are you the one?
Artist? I wouldn't classify myself as an artist, no.
Who's the artist? Mm-hmm. Is someone here that's an artist? You? Oh, okay.
Yeah, so, more.
What do you do? What kind of art do you do?
I draw. It's not like fine art. You give me something and I can usually replicate it. I can do it. I've painted murals on walls.
Oh, wow.
She teaches Tai Chi?
I do.
Hey, I got it right?
You did?
Yes.
Ooh, all right.
It's not easy.
So, yeah. And one thing that I've seen with it, I am so grateful for this show, the TV station, because it teaches us how to have more confidence in ourselves.
Yeah.
And we have great camera people.
Oh, yeah.
And we really do, you know. They take the time to take the time when... I always lean back, but they used to be by now, you know. But one of the things I don't know if I would be violating your beliefs or not, but if I tell you from just a spirit that crossed over that's very proud of you, what would you say?
It'd be encouraging.
Okay, I don't want you to, I don't want to do something, because there's an older lady that has passed.
Okay.
And she told, like a grandmother on your father's side, and has told me how proud she is that you did not get into trouble, how proud she is of you doing the work of God.
Oh, well, that's wonderful.
And she's also telling me, and she's actually tapping her eye, she also says she knows you very well, and she always knew that you would be doing something worthwhile.
Oh, well, that's, well, I offer thanks for that. Okay. And I try to do my best to honor those who have poured so much into me.
Right. There are some people that, when you as a child growing up, didn't understand the path you were following. Mm-hmm. Because you made better, you bettered yourself. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
You had to work your way through college.
Yeah, I sure did.
Nothing was given to you.
Nope.
Don't you think we appreciate it more when we work for everything
exactly.
we have?
That's why I can relate to what you're talking about with things with, you have to hit rock bottom in order to be able to, to see the bright side.
You're right. And your dad is really proud of you.
Of course. My dad is like my twin.
You have a special relationship, don't you?
Mm-hmm.
That was interesting that you said that. That this is going to be really weird what I said.
All right.
And your dad were twins way back in your past life.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I always wish there was a way I could prove this to people when I talk about past life. Don't you?
Mm-hmm.
You do that, right? You talk about.
I do. I don't look at it as a past life, though. I kind of think that they're kind of side by side.
Don't bang
on
the table.
Oh, sorry.
You'll get yelled at.
Tapping on the table. The sound.
Paul has a very loud voice. Don't you, Paul? But I really do. You actually worked as with Jesus Christ. You knew him. This is why you were destined to be where you are today. In all your life, you've always held the religious area. You were also locked up in a cell as a young, way back in your past life, in a dungeon, like, because you were such a strong Christian.
Really? I haven't been in your past life before.
Yeah. I wish he would. I honestly wish there was a way I could prove all of this stuff, because I think it would be interesting but I would tell you to go look in Roman history and the Christianity, what Christian had to do with the. Now I know you're going to do this because you're going to be curious now. Okay. But I also know this is what could happen with you. I also will also know that you are going to be a very young lady that's going to be very special to you.
Oh, well, thank you.
And she's going to honor what you believe in.
Thank you.
And you're going to put her with you. You're not going to make her below you. You're not going to make her above you. You're going to be equal.
Well, we can't do that. That's not the healthy way to do things, to keep people under your feet.
No. I can remember when I was in the Born Again Christian. First come God, which is obvious. Then it come man.
And this was in California, right?
This is in New Hampshire.
New Hampshire, okay.
Right. After I left college, I came here.
Right.
And then they had first had God, then they had Jesus, then they had the man, then the woman had to be below the man. And I said, I can't deal with that.
Uh-huh.
And plus being gay, they went, oh, that was taboo to begin with, And plus, I used to belong to an Indian group. And boy, I had an odd.
Do you have any Native American heritage?
No.
Okay. You would just hang out.
I would just tag along.
Being in community with them. Okay.
I was actually interested in the history of it.
Okay.
No, I am Scots.
Scott, all right.
Okay. I'm Scots and Irish, they say. Maybe that's where I got the beer drinking from.
Yeah.
But my whole family were alcoholics. So. And I'm not saying, I made that choice. Actually, when my family found out that I was gay,
I'm so sorry.
Oh, no, that's okay today.
Yeah.
I get along great with a couple of my nephews, nieces and nephews, so that's we made amends, and that's okay. I love who I am today.
Good.
If you don't love who you are in the world of life, then I feel so sorry for you.
It's hard to love others if you don't love yourself.
I can't preach to someone to look in the mirror and tell you that you're a winner today if I don't believe it myself.
Right.
I can't preach those words. It's easier for me to say, to tell Eric, I want you to go look in the mirror completely naked, and I really mean this and not being dirty, and to say, I am a winner today, because I think you still need to learn that.
Well, we've always got to, always encourage ourselves and remind ourselves, that we can make it. There is a brighter tomorrow. There's a brighter, not the brighter tomorrow, brighter today.
Right. Every day is a new day.
Mm-hmm.
We can't change yesterday. I learned that in AA too.
You can't change. You can't change yesterday, but you have some agency over what can happen today. Yeah. And every day you get up, there's hope that tomorrow can be better than what yesterday was. Right.
Your grandmother told me to write you a book.
My grandmother said, "Write me a book."
For you. Not right away. You're going to be writing a book.
Well, that's more things to do.
But you have to keep busy.
Told you, I'm trying to do less and less.
Yeah, but you know what? You have to keep busy. I'm trying to do less. You know? We always try to, you know, the more we try to do less, have you found this? The more we end up. Yeah. Like, I'd retire from nursing.
Okay, so you did that as a career too.
Right.
Okay.
Okay. And I said, I'd retire now. I know I have found that I am doing more now, but I love more what I do today. It's not forceful. I choose my hours. I choose what I want to do. You know? Mm-hmm. I love having the people come in the office. Like the other late day, I had a lady come in and email me, and she said, "Thank you for something that happened 13 years ago." I go,
wow.
What did I do 13 years ago? You know?
And is that what brought you to New Hampshire nursing?
Yeah.
Okay.
I got hired at the state school in Laconia for the mentally challenged. And so, you should have seen me. If I had to sign a contract with him, I probably wouldn't have had a job. I came with the long hair and the beard and the lumbies and all that stuff, you know, back in the 60s. Oh, yeah. I probably would have never.
That's California.
That's right. So you brought California with you.
That's right. I'm originally from New Hampshire when I went to school in the town.
Okay, okay. What part of New Hampshire were you originally from?
Springfield, New Hampshire.
Springfield, New Hampshire, okay.
You know where that is?
No, I don't.
All right, you know where New London, New Hampshire is?
Yep.
All right, right next town.
Oh, okay.
Okay. When I left there, I vowed I would never go back there, and I didn't. Only for a couple of times.
Okay, got it.
But then I went back there, and I was. See, we can let go of our anger. Okay, there's a way, like my friend Bob took me up to, after I got my eyesight back, within 45 minutes I had surgery done, I got my eyesight back, you know. And I went to the town I grew up in, and I found out, I don't have to be mad at the town. Why am I mad at the town? The town's not mad at me, it's the people. I went over to my where I grew up, and I screamed, I yelled, I cried, and you know, my friend never babied me, he just let me express myself.
Okay. You know, and so you just listen.
Let me get rid of it all. And I'm still, every day we still have to, you know. If everybody thinks that we're perfect, well, of course I am, but, you know, that's beside the point. No, I love to kid around. But are we perfect today?
No.
Would you want to be?
In due time. I don't think that's a tough question. I don't think I can answer that right now.
Thank you. How about you?
I find it to be very boring.
Well, we wouldn't have any challenges, wouldn't right? we? The only one that's perfect is a higher power.
There's nothing to strive for if you're perfect.
Right. That's right. When I used to evaluate people, they'd say, well, how come you don't have that perfect? I said, because then you're not allowing yourself to grow.
Mm-hmm.
You have to grow. You know, we have what I like to call a spiritual well. You know, it's like a deep water well. But only it has like a all marble and all that beautiful stairs, climbing up the stairs. And when it has a green vine coming down, and as you're climbing, there's a little water trickling down through.
Yeah.
And as you're climbing up those spiritual stairs, you know, we're going to fall back.
That's right.
And then we grab that vine and we start building back up again. Mm-hmm. We slip down, move forward, slip down, you know.
Right.
We can, that's like when I see the people. I would love to have somebody go with me, just go visit some of these homeless people.
Yeah.
You know, I've actually been blessed. And sometime when I do it again, I'll let you know.
Mm-hmm.
I've actually walked into, over to the park where I live across the street from a park where some of the gang members are. And I said, Spirit, I'm doing what you told me to do, you know. And you would do the thing. You wouldn't be afraid, you know. And I walk in there and I say, you know, you don't have to ruin your life this way. And I looked at one kid. I said, how old are you? He said, 14. I said, why are you doing this to your mother?
What did he say?
And he says, this is my family. I go, no, they're not. And I said, I don't want to see your blood on the street. And he started to get this race card. I go, no, I'm not talking about color. I'm talking about you. And I said, you're smart. I said, you really think this guy who's a leader, he said, I like to fight. I looked at the guy and said, anytime you want to fight with me, when I got a stronger, higher power that will intervene for me. And I talked to this kid, and he was so smart. And then 4 months later, his mother ran into me. She said, thank you. I go, you know, I don't remember anything. Do you?
No.
No. And she says to me, thank you. I go, for what? You helped save my son. He's getting his life back together. like the Teen Challenge. You must have heard of Teen Challenge.
Yes, okay? I have.
Yeah. And that's what makes it all worthwhile. Like what you do, what you touch many people's lives, whether you realize it or not. Like Mary, you touched her life at that meeting that you, when the Martin Luther King Day, you touched her life. And then the NAACP, you touched many other people's lives. And what do you do as a president there?
Well, the president is supposed to be the face of the branch and is responsible for presiding over meetings and helping with the day-to-day operations of the branch.
And you enjoy it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, it keeps you busy?
Yes, it does. It keeps me plenty of busy.
Well, you would let me know. You may want to stop working, get busy, and you want to slow down, but you know what? That's not who you are.
Well, you know, my body is telling me that I have to.
I know, but I'm telling you, your mind is always going to be. Go for acupuncture.
Well, I'll give it a try. I never did acupuncture before. Tell me about acupuncture. Does it hurt? What is it? Tell me.
Never had to tell it. I always tell people to go.
No, it doesn't hurt.
It doesn't hurt at all.
I haven't had it.
What happens? What's the purpose of acupuncture?
Have you had it?
I've done a lot of acupuncture. They do acupuncture on me on a regular basis to try to help with my pain.
Mm-hmm. That does help?
It calms it down. It doesn't get rid of it.
Well, and they'll never say no cure. I mean, right. If anybody said, that's like we do a Reiki energy, and I do right. that mm-hmm. my own.
It probably depends on what you're like. You're yeah. at a different level than,
right.
you know,
yeah. right.
when average Joe walking in. Yeah.
When I do Reiki energy, I call it spiritual energy because mm-hmm. that Reiki is so commonly used.
It's a specific name, yeah.
For yeah, that. And when I work on the person's body, and when I do it, I take all the negative out. You know, we work together. We take all the negative pain and energy mm-hmm. out of their body. Okay, but we do it together. We're like with you. Mm-hmm. You're a tool that mm-hmm. helps people.
Correct.
Because you do Tai Chi, that mm-hmm. helps people, right?
Yeah.
You know, so every person, like you, when you're preaching, you're a tool of the or an instrument of the higher power.
You know, that's the goal. The goal is to do our best on Sunday morning, and other times throughout the week, to represent. You know, I stand as a, you know, stand trying to do my best to proclaim God's word.
And you are.
And that's the goal. And that's the goal is to represent not me, but to represent God.
Right, and that's the way I look at it. I'm only a tool. I'm only a messenger for the higher power or the spirit. I call it the universal spirit, okay?
Okay.
And there's a lot of reasons for that, but I'm not going to go into
all
that,
right.
okay? Because the way I used to be addressed at it, it was so, I just don't want to do it. I prefer and I get respect for it. Mm-hmm. I don't care what a person calls them. Because as long as we respect the higher power, I usually have a Buddha here, but I'm not going to be using it anymore. But as long as we have the belief in our spiritual being, doing harm to no one, loving people and caring for people, but also make sure that you take care of yourself so that you can take care of others.
That's right.
Phew, that was a big statement for me.
That was a long one.
Wasn't it? Oh,
good.
My gosh.
you did all right. You did great.
Yeah. But don't you agree?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you know, it's important to care for others. And,
yeah.
You know, I don't believe religion and faith should call us to harm each other.
No. And that's the sad part. There's so many people. I don't care if you're Muslim. I don't care if you're Buddha. I don't care. There's always a bad core in every religion.
Mm-hmm.
Always, you know, what do you call it? And, you know, I have a lot of friends that are Muslims, and they're great friends of mine.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I have a lot of friends that are Buddhas. I have a lot of friends. I don't look at it that way. I don't look at anybody being as a spiritual name. I look, you know, a religious name like Catholic, Baptist, or whatever. I look at them as all spiritually divided.
Yeah.
And we can all be that way.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what we gotta do. We gotta get rid of that hate. Mm-hmm. Listen to me. You think I was in a pulpit here?
I think you are.
Wow.
You have your own.
This
he
is
got, he got
your
his
show.
Right there. That's he right. got right. Got the microphone. Got the desk.
Yeah. See, I'm on
and,
a roll.
And he's doing it note free. No, not one piece of paper open. No papers.
No, never, never.
No papers. See,
I had a lady come in. I don't know if I ever told you this story. Mm-hmm. I invited her. Her husband came on the show. And she said, well, this is what we're going to be talking about. This is what we're going to be doing. I go, no. I said, what did you just say to me? And she said, well, you know how I feel about that, right?
Yeah.
I said, oh, you want me to ask? Oh, yeah, these are the questions you're going to ask me. I go, really? And I said, oh, okay. May I look at them, please? She said, oh, yeah, here. I said, oh, my goodness, they've got color in the garbage.
What did she say?
How dare you? I go, I don't do a question-answer show.
What kind of show do you do? So tell me more about what you do.
Oh, my show here, and I want everybody, well, you can explain it better.
Okay.
Oh, you I don't come know if I can explain it.
Well, you've been on my show, what, 3-4 times?
I have, yeah. He'll invite guests on, and they basically show, you know, they talk about what they do, which is nice. And he showcases
keep
that.
To right back.
Okay.
Now, this is part of the co-hosting.
Oh, good. Oh, good. I'm on.
You know, then you know.
I'm on. I can't wait. No, I mean, that's what it is. It's nice. He brings different groups on, different people, and they just highlight what they do. They talk about what they do.
Okay.
And, you know, then he does his thing. Sometimes they do readings back and forth. So.
Okay.
So it is nice. It's a nice little community show.
Good.
With the call-ins. We haven't had any calls about the movie. What's up with that?
I know.
People are waiting.
It's a good thing.
I already know the answer.
Well, see, it's good that you do, because I recognize the faces, but I'm old enough that I don't remember the names anymore. So.
We'll talk about it on the way home.
Like, I have one name. I do, and I almost have another name, but I don't remember the movie.
I do.
I knew you'd know the movie.
Now, where did you start preaching?
I served at the First Calvary Baptist Church. That was the first church that I was called to as an associate pastor. Are you affiliated with any faith community?
Earth.
All right.
That's a good place to start.
Right. Mm-hmm. Yeah, no, I'm baptized as an Episcopalian, but I don't go on a regular basis.
Okay.
But
here in Manchester?
It's St. John's over in Portsmouth.
Okay.
I'm from Elliott. I grew up in Kittery.
Okay.
But
cool. I'm quite familiar with Portsmouth.
Yeah. Good town.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. good
town. Pretty popular one, too, in New Hampshire.
Yeah.
It is.
Yeah,
it's good.
But, yeah, I know.
So, are you on the show regularly, too?
I'm her driver. I'm her Uber.
Got it. Got it.
And I usually just sit over there. I don't know why I got called up today, but
we'll find out.
Well, you have a good story to tell, so I think normally.
Yes, I didn't mean to steal your thunder. I didn't come up here to steal your thunder.
There's room for everybody. Right. Room for all.
Yeah. What's that?
Getting closer to your mics.
Closer, okay.
Bring right up to you.
Pull it closer.
Well, yeah. Another thing I like to do, remember. I have a lot of people, like I have people that have MS, they come, they talk about how they're progressing.
Yeah.
We've had people with autism that play guitar.
Mm-hmm.
We're doing, it's a community. And we had one young lady who came in, and she was like 14, 12 or 13 years old, and her family was destitute, but that didn't stop her. She happened to get burned out. She went to the Saturday Haunted Trail.
Okay,
to raise money for people less fortunate than she was for Christmas.
Wow.
So to me, that's what's worth coming on to, you know. I want to show that people, like young kids that can sing or they think they can sing or whatever, I want the community, you know, and then that's what I want it to be. That's why I'm now calling it a Norm's Community
Corner. Okay.
Because I want them to know that everybody's welcome to come on.
Okay.
And I think that, like when you come on, it was an honor. Do you have to go now, or are you?
Well, yeah, I do in a little bit.
Okay.
I do have to get ready to head to another meeting. Uh-huh. I actually got to head to Brookside Church.
Uh-huh. And where is that located?
2013 Elm Street.
And you are who?
Eric Jackson. I'm the pastor at Brookside. And, you know, you asked me earlier about events. I also want to let people know that on the 29th of April at 3 o'clock p.m., I will be, we're going to be having my installation service at 3 o'clock p.m. at Brookside.
Your installation?
Yes. So basically, that's a time where we come together as the our local association for our denomination and the church and I.
Oh, I see.
And we just have a celebration.
Oh, well, that's good.
Yeah.
Well, I'm going to thank you for coming on.
So thank you for having me. And thank you for asking me.
I would like to have you come back on again.
All right. We'll do it.
All right. Next time, we'll do dinner.
All right.
All right. Thank you, sir. Many love.
So good to see you.
Nice to meet you.
So good seeing you.
Good to meet you.
Good to meet you, Eric.
It's a great name, isn't it?
I know. Tell me about it.
Eric, too?
Yeah, yes.
Okay. See you next time.
All right.
Yep.
Bye.
You say yeah. Pull that mic right up like this to you. Okay. I gotta get off Facebook here. I gotta make an announcement here.
Okay.
I thought I was just driving you.
See? You never know. You never know when I'm sure.
Okay. I got a message here. Let me see my goggles here. Okay, we have an announcement. Free events on Friday, April 13th. Infinity Journey LLC to Starwood Drive in Hampstead, New Hampshire. It's having an open house from 5 to 9 p.m. That's in Hampstead, New Hampshire.
Right back in front of you. Like this. Right back in front of you.
There you go, just perfect. Like this. There you go. A little bit closer. You okay?
And then, on TV. Thanks.
Yeah. Then, and cares from starting from 6:30 with free octane training in Towsted Ridge Country Club, 40 Scales Lane in Towsted, Mass. And it's open to the public. And the other one's also open to the public. This is done by Bridget Morris. Morris and Amy Majors.
Ah, okay.
Okay, they're going to be doing the new kid. So this is this coming Saturday, whatever, from 9 to p.m. Infinite Journey LLC at 2 Starwood Drive in Hampstead, New Hampshire, from 5 p.m. to 9. And then that's NM Cares from starting at 6:30 with free dark cane training for Townstead Ridge Country Club, 40 Scale Street. You know? You know. Oh, I forgot. I got to re-message her. But anyway, so who are you?
I'm Eric.
Eric.
We've met before.
I know. But you're going to, the other people haven't.
Hi, I'm Eric.
Okay. And you.
Once you've been in front of the camera.
Right. Yeah.
You know. Yeah, you were here before.
Yep.
Were you on the air?
Yeah, I was here on the air for a year ago.
Yeah, it was almost.
I was here with the STIRS team, the paranormal group that I'm with.
Okay. That's right. I apologize for not remembering.
No worries.
So many people.
You remember?
A lot of people that day.
Yeah. We had four of us.
Five.
Of us. There was a whole tribe of us.
On the end, that when the spirit actually came and talked to her.
Yes.
You know, and she's still with the group.
She is.
Yes.
You know. So you're retired.
Not by choice. Yeah.
But you're finding things to do to take care of your life, right?
I am right now, yeah. I'm working on it. They keep me very busy.
Yeah. So one of the things I'm looking at with you, too, is you have overcome a lot of stress and pain.
Just a touch.
I'm not saying it's not, and then it's gone. Don't get me wrong.
No, I ain't saying.
But I still see it being there.
Oh, yeah.
But it's not as bad. You're learning how to tolerate it. One thing I'd actually recommend to you is probably, like I said, you said you go to acupuncture?
Yep.
Do you ever get Reiki energy?
She was doing Reiki on me for a while. I had to stop, but I probably need to start going back.
I would probably, not no offense to you, okay, because you two know each other too well. I would suggest that you go to someone, maybe one of your, because you teach it as well?
I do, yeah.
Okay, I would probably go to one of her students.
Right.
Because sometimes when you get to know each other too well, that the energy can be not the way it should be.
Right. I will be starting Tai Chi with her here shortly.
Mm-hmm. Oh, God, another one.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. It's very good.
I'm bringing another friend of mine on that does Tai Chi, so it'll be interesting to compare how you do it with how he does it.
Well, it depends. Yeah, it depends. I do it because I'm a secondary black belt in Shaolin Kempo, too.
Yeah, he also, too. But I mean, I think what would be interesting is about how you talk about how, the techniques or how it can help people and all that. I've seen this being when he was down and out. I mean, literally, his ex-wife, she was a monster. And took, he had a business going about 100,000 a year, if not more. And his beloved ex-wife, and I can say this, because I know her. And she took everything from him.
Wow.
And now he's starting all over again, and he's really doing a lot better. If you believe, that's where the spirit works, okay? Mm-hmm. Yeah, I do these on you.
Certainly, sir.
Okay. Are you in a relationship right now? You married?
I am married.
Married quite a while?
28 years.
How does she put up with you?
She lives with me. She.
I'm only picking on you.
No. She went through a lot of cast iron pans.
Yeah.
Yeah. But.
But one of the things about you, you're not a quitter at whatever you decide to do.
I try not to. I don't like quitting.
No, because don't we feel like... that was a great guest I had, wasn't he?
He was.
He was very good.
Nice that, energy.
That's what I want to do my second event.
Yeah, very
and
nice.
When
energy.
I get your application, I'll send it to you. You know, couple of those. Want to show that question again, Paul?
Sure.
I know no bites on it yet.
No, they probably don't know. Now, if it's a musical, they would do it.
Well, that's very true.
Forgive me, because I have no feeling
that's
in my
right.
left hand.
No, that's right. All I want is just your energy.
Yeah, no, I just...
Not your peanut. It's not that quick.
Your peanut butter? Is that
what yeah, you peanut butter. Yeah, I don't want your peanut butter energy.
Okay. Okay, so the folks at home are looking at it right now.
Yeah.
It's the two actors in the movie that they have to guess.
Okay. The first one that can get that movie right... And the two actors, I will give you a 10-minute free reading on the air. So pay attention to it, and it's all up to you folks if you want to join us.
That's right.
Now we're going to do a reading on, oh boy, what we're going to tell him.
Oh,
you were quite aroused about as a young man, weren't you?
I would say that again?
You were quite aroused about.
I had
your share of fun.
I had my ways.
Just say yes, Eric.
Yes.
Just say yes.
Yeah.
It's okay to
well,
say
my mother
yes.
might be watching. I don't know.
It's okay to say yes.
Well, she knows. Yes. Mothers know.
Oh, yeah, she knows. Okay. I just
but
left
she
her
also
house.
Take out five cards. But she left. Also knows you.
Yes, I just left her house today for lunch, and she's told me a lot of stories about, and I'm like, how did you even know that?
Mothers know. Even my foster mother. Yeah.
Mothers know.
My mother always
say
they have eyes in the back of
they
their head.
Always. It's the psychic sense.
The mothers seem to know.
Yeah, it's funny.
Is she watching?
I don't know if she's watching right now because I didn't tell her I was actually going to be on the show. I just said I was driving to the show.
You have a motorcycle?
I do.
Pretty careful with it, huh? Well, I'm going to suggest you be a little more careful.
It's kind of funny. I had a motorcycle accident in 2012.
Okay.
A woman hit me. She ran a red light.
Okay, but the next one will be your fault.
Will be my fault? Oh.
No. I'm going to encourage you to wear a helmet.
Always do.
I'm also going to be aware of the surroundings around you.
I try to do that as much as possible.
There's something that's going to be something that mishap, maybe a tune or something. There's some kind of a mishap that's going to happen, but actually it will be your fault. Mm-hmm. You know, you're going through a red line or something like that. And usually you're pretty cautious if you're on the bike.
Mm-hmm.
But this is one thing that, you know, it's just an absent mind. Maybe you're dreaming about her. I don't know, but it's just an absent mind or whatever, you know. I also tell you, King of Diamonds tell me, do you have a son?
No, I do not. I have someone that I consider a son, but he's not a blood.
He's like a stepson?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yep.
As far as I'm concerned, that's a son.
Yep.
Okay. I hate that word step. I really
well, he's not from my wife or my wife's marriage.
Okay.
He was one of my junior firefighters.
Okay.
And
well, you're very close to him.
Very close to him.
And you teach him a lot of good things.
I have taught him everything that I could.
And I also will tell you, he confides in you a lot.
Yep.
One of the things I want you to understand, when he comes crying to you, please, please listen.
Mm-hmm.
Because he doesn't have the greatest home life. Okay. One thing I also will tell you that you have a great heart and you care for a lot of other people. Now it's time for you to start taking care of you.
Hmm.
Okay. It's time for you to say, you know what, you can take care of and you will be better for it. Instead of trying to teach other people how to do things, you have to teach yourself first. You can hide behind what she and I encourage you to go to her for Tai Chi or whatever, but make sure you're damn well doing it for the right reason.
Right.
Okay. Not to hide from it. You got to learn that you're a great person. Eric, right?
Yep.
Oh, my God, I got
you
it
did.
Twice.
You did.
Oh, my God, I'm getting better. You really do love the lady you're with, aren't you?
Yes, I do.
She loves you, too.
I would hope so.
Are you legally married? Are you?
Nope, yep.
Okay. Well, that's his first around here.
I know. That happens very often.
You actually got like 32 more years.
Oh, good God. Okay. Yeah. No.
She's probably gone.
Does she have arthritis?
Yeah.
She has a lot of arthritis, but she doesn't complain.
Not a lot.
Well, and that can be pretty bad for her. You over-complain her.
I over-complain her? Yeah, I guess I could in some
when
areas.
You get on the pity pot, you can really get on the pity pot. But then when you feel boastful and you feel like energy, you can really do that. I'm not trying to be mean when I say
No, I understand. I'm just, I don't.
But I want you to reevaluate your own status.
Right.
That's what I'm doing, by the way, okay?
Yeah, nope.
Now you were in a you were in a fire.
I was.
Okay. Now something blew up around you.
I've had things blown up around me quite a bit.
You got pretty bad. You got pretty badly hurt.
A few times.
Yeah.
Okay. I mean, I've been injured a few times. And
one thing I also will tell you, you have a cracky doctor.
Yes.
Okay. He's not doing a darn thing to help.
No, he's not.
He likes the money.
Yes.
Okay. I would also tell you to get a different doctor. Can I see there's some healing that can come into your body?
Okay. We are actually, believe it or not, we are working on that.
Okay. I actually will tell you, you can do a lot of your own healing. Okay. You agree with that, right?
Yes, I've been.
Good teacher here. I don't know how to talk to her. She's a no-nonsense teacher.
Yeah, that's why she's getting me into Tai Chi.
You know.
Because the Tai Chi will help me heal myself.
That's right. And you can also, I would recommend, and I want to see if you agree with me, that you lay for 10 minutes a day flat on your back on the floor. No having your wife lay near you because that might cause problems, but you know what I mean. But for as long as you can stand and lay completely straight for like 10 minutes a day on your back, because your spine is way out of culture and your hip is up here. Okay, you know what I mean? It should be a way. Mm-hmm. So I would probably encourage you to lay like for 10 minutes. And it's going to hurt like heck. I'm not going to tell you what's going to. And remember, folks, I am not a doctor. I am not a registered orthopedic surgeon. I am a spiritualist.
Right.
Okay, with a healing tune. Does that make sense to you?
It does. Yep.
Okay, so I would probably.
You are 100% correct. Okay. It will hurt like heck.
Yes, it will. But you know what? It'll get better as you go. And then the 10 minutes will seem like 15. And,
right.
You know, start out first 5 to 10 minutes a day. But you can't give up on it. You got to keep it going. Because if you quit on that, you'll quit on anything else.
Right.
And I don't want to see that happening. I also will tell you, you do have very close to needing a hearing aid.
I can see that coming.
Okay.
That's
I know right now people think you have selective hearing. And if you, rather than to have an argument, you pretend you don't hear or you'll walk away. If they really won't let you have, I mean, if they really want your opinion, then they better expect you're going to give it, and it may not always be in the kindest way of doing it.
Right. And that's usually why I tend to walk away, because.
You have a pretty enraged temper when you get angry. And you've had that since a child.
Yes.
Okay. But you also, you never went to YDC, right? Youth Detention Center or anything like that? You've come pretty close. You don't have to answer.
No, I've come very close.
Okay.
Very close.
Is your dad passed?
No.
Okay.
No.
I have to let you know, I am talking with him now, however. He told me to tell you that he's very proud of you. Okay. You have a good relationship with him?
We're working on it. Actually, the older we get, the better. Right. We had it was real rocky at first, but. Yeah.
Well, both of you are too much alike.
Yes.
Okay. And you're always going to be mama's boy.
I have no choice. I'm the only son.
Well, you can do no wrong. Okay. Your wife had to prove to your mother that she was worth you.
Yes, she did. That is God's honest truth.
And she really, now she has, your mother approves of her now.
Wholeheartedly.
Okay. Who's the better cook, you or your wife?
Me.
And she'll tell you that, right?
Yes, she will. I cannot bake to save my life, but she can.
No,
but
she can. My partner does all the cooking, all the baking. I'm spoiled.
It's nice.
I love it. Last night, my granddaughter made a fettuccine, and it was so good. And she made carrot cake. It was so good. She had to make sure Grandpa had some. That was even better than anything in the world, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And then I had another friend of mine bring over pea soup. You like pea soup?
No, but I make it.
Yeah? Do you like pea soup?
I do,
too. She made it. It was so good with ham in it, you know?
Yeah.
Oh, my God. And my friend Paul just came home from the doctor's, from the hospital, and he had... They're worried about having clots in his heart, you know. So I have so many wonderful friends, you know. Oh, okay. Hello, Al. Oh, my God. I'm going to call him back. Al, let me call you back. I hate my cell phone.
Yeah, I think we all go through that on a routine basis. I think they're possessed sometimes.
Yeah.
They have a mind of their own.
Yes, they do. And I don't like it. Yeah.
Hello,
Al. Hey, Howard, sorry about that, Al. I hit the wrong button. How you doing today? Oh, I hit the wrong button, Matt. I lost it. Sorry about that. Hey, oh, that was an amazing game, wasn't it? Well, you know what? We're going to do really well. We're going to go to the playoffs. I'm a little bit worried about the World Series, but we're going to go. And I also believe that the Brewers are going to build back up.
Yeah,
you know. So how are you doing today? Yeah. We're going to come back. We're going to come back big and strong. If we get the referees that will call and plays fair, you know?
Yeah.
You know, so, you know, and like that. Actually, I think it's going very well. What do you think?
I'm having fun.
Yeah, we had Reverend Eric Jackson. He's a leader of the NAACP.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, you know. And we're planning our next event July 20th, Al.
July 20th. Okay, you're doing it in the summer. Okay.
Yeah.
Hopefully it won't be hot that day. We'll have to make it cooler for
you. Well, that's right. I'll have to make sure there's a nice air conditioner. You know, I don't like the heat. Oh, God, I hate the heat.
I'm not a fan of it either.
You're not in Arizona. It's been in the 90s this week. You're not in Phoenix. I think
there
were 100 yesterday, a little over.
Right. Oh, yeah. Well, I have a friend of mine that lives in Arizona, and I think one day was 110.
Wow. Yeah, and get to 120 there in the sun. Even a little high.
I think that's a little.
Yeah, you know. So, yeah. So, we'll get into the forecast. Tonight, we're going to have some clouds around, low temperatures in the upper 20s and low 30s. Tomorrow, we're going to have generally a day featuring a mostly cloudy sky. There could be a few rain showers around tomorrow. Temperatures of a warm front can get just north of us in the extreme southern, southeastern area. So, may get in the mid 50s in the afternoon. Friday, will be in the mid 60s, mixed sun and clouds. Then Saturday, you may start warm. It may jump to 60 or a little higher by morning, lunchtime, and you could briefly get in the 60s. That's going to turn sharply colder with a big temperature drop late Saturday afternoon or evening. Timing rules uncertain. There's a strong backdoor cold front that will move from northeast, southwest, coming down from Maine. And Sunday will only be in the upper 30s to 40 with drizzle. Then maybe a widespread, moderate to heavy rain event with a low pressure approaching the Great Lakes Sunday night. And it looks wet for the running of the Boston Marathon next Monday.
Yeah. Well, you know, that's my kind of weather when it's nice and cool.
That's right. You'll like Sunday. It's only going to be in the upper 30s to around 40. You're going to like Sunday, though.
That's a good thing, you know.
So, now, let me finish the show. Did you want to meet? I have in the morning. I just have to get this class service.
Okay, yeah. Let's put,
Did you want to?
Why don't we wait till next week?
You want to do next week?
Yeah. We'll put on next Thursday. I got a busy day. Yeah, I got a busy day tomorrow. Yeah, so let's put it on next Thursday, okay?
All right, and I'll give you a call over the weekend, Sunday.
Yeah.
Everyone, have a great rest of the show.
And you too. Yeah, have a great. Bye-bye now.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. You know who that is? Yeah, brilliant, one of my best friends, actually.
I miss his weather.
I do, too.
They treated him like garbage.
That's back when weathermen were actually accurate.
They were, yep.
You know, he was the most accurate one. That's why they let him go.
Yeah.
You know, I also will tell you there's some things happening to renew your relationship with your wife.
Good.
You got to stop taking each other for granted. You got to have more communication. When was the last time you said, "Hi, I love you"?
This morning.
And really meant it? Or was it just a passing word? I love it when I meet people think.
I
A lot of people say, hi, I love you, and you're just as big. But really, you know, what I'm doing is open the door of communication a little bit more. Don't be afraid to talk to each other.
Right.
Okay. No, okay. Because that means you take it. You have a dog.
Yeah, you have three dogs. Yeah.
Three dogs. And boy, they really love you, don't they?
Yes, they do.
But they love your wife more.
Damn jerks. All right.
They're very protective of her.
They are extremely protective.
And that's a good thing.
Yes.
Especially if you're not there.
Yep.
You know. You live in God's country?
I live in Elliott. It's not really God's country, but it's kind of woodsy.
Do they have running water, electricity up there?
Yeah.
Sometimes.
Okay. Yeah, sometimes.
You don't have to run out to the outhouse?
No, but I have one for backup.
There you go. I actually grew up in a very small town, so, yep. You know. And I always said never again. But I also will tell you that there's someone that is coming to make amends with you. Someone that looks like a man. Someone who kind of like betrayed you maybe 10 years ago or 15 years ago. And he hurt you emotionally. But I actually look at him making amends with you. And please, he really means it. He's okay. Someone who had, I don't know if you know, and there's a K, like a Keith or a Kenny or whatever his name. You may not remember it now. Because you don't remember people who have done betrayal to you. You soon let it all go. You're also learning how to forgive.
Yes, I've been practicing.
Are you forgiving
that.
You?
Am I forgiving me?
Yeah.
I've been working on it.
Yeah. Because you have to learn how to forgive you so that you can forgive others.
Right.
And that's a rough road to have. Mm-hmm. I've had to do a lot of self-forgiving. Have you?
Yes, I think we all have. We all do.
The most important about that's the whole thing. And by the way, I love your spirituality. Just stop doubting yourself so much. You are where you're supposed to be in the life, whether it's spiritual life or whatever. You are where you're supposed to be. Financially, I'm not going to tell you you're going to be a multimillionaire, but you're going to be okay.
I'd like to hear that.
Okay. You want to sell your house?
No.
Okay.
What, do you want to buy it?
No. I don't want to live in Maine.
Hey,
now. I know, you had running water out there, yeah. That's a Democrat state.
We have sort of clean air.
Oh, okay.
Yes, yeah,
actually, sort of. I was up in Maine, up in, way, way up where the Kobe College is up in Maine.
Yeah, that's a little ways up.
Yeah, quite a ways up there. And where Stephen King lives.
Yeah,
okay. That was the most cleanest city I've ever seen in all my travels. Mm. That's where Job Corps is, all that.
Yep.
And I got to tell you, that was one of the cleanest areas I've ever been in. my understanding, if you get caught with throwing a piece of paper on the ground, there's a big fine. You know, and I think there should be.
Right.
Oh, I got to tell you, man, you two, your relationship is forever and a day.
I'm okay with that.
Okay. Well, you don't have no choice. Yeah. You do. I shouldn't say that because everybody had choices. You play guitar?
I used to. After the accident, I had to stop because I couldn't feel the keys.
Well, you need
I mean,
to
the
get
strings.
Okay, but you really need to get back into it again.
Yeah, I could try.
And don't give up on. Don't say try. Say I
well,
can.
Yeah, but okay.
No.
I know where you're going, and I. Yeah.
Because it's going to build up your texture.
I've been thinking about it, but the whole thing of being able to feel the frets and knowing where everything is, that was the whole problem.
The thing is, how long has it been?
2012.
Okay. The thing is, now it's time for you to get some mobility into your fingers.
Yep.
It's time for you to get to feeling of the mobility. It's time to get that growing. And no more I can try. I want it. The next time you come on, because you're going to be coming on again, I'm sure. But the next time you come on, I want to hear you say that. I don't care if you play Mary Had a Little Lamb, or I don't care what you play. Or you're going to get frustrated. No doubt. Because you get frustrated very easily.
Oh, yes, I do.
Okay. And it's going to because you're a perfectionist. And you can't be that much of a perfectionist. Then that's what frustrates you. One of the reasons why Spirit had you in the actual key was because you were having an ego trip where everything had to be done a certain way, you know. That brought you down, even though it sounds bad, but in the end, it's teaching you how to be motivating and helping you to help other people. Okay. Where I have a feeling you could have been a little self-centered before the accident.
I was cocky.
Self-centered, yeah. You know. I mean, and now, isn't it amazing how spirit works and changes right? around there, you know? You got three cavities.
Probably more.
But I'm just saying right now, see, the three that you really need to get taken care of.
Okay.
Okay. When your wife gets upset, I would clear the room until she calms down.
I usually tend to let her...
But you instigate it.
I think those are two fair statements right there. Yep,
I would never do that.
You want to see she's alive. You know. And well, she can swear.
Oh, well,
she's
yes.
She's got that fisherman's wife, right?
Yeah, yeah. Okay.
But I also know that she gets over it very quickly, too. But she can hold a grudge for a long
time. Yeah, she can. She can hold a very long grudge.
And you know, the sad part is she's a very strong spiritual person.
Yeah.
She just has to find her own path. And it will come in time. You have to set the example. No more candy. No more sugar. No more salt. Am I hitting it where it hurts?
Well, I'm not a huge sugar component. But she is, and I've been trying to get her to...
Okay, both of you, okay. While you setting an example
right.
for her doing that, and but, she really loves her sweets.
Yes, okay, yes, she does.
And that's why she has a lot of problems with sugar levels.
Yeah.
Because it goes up to here, down to here. I know I don't have her permission, but I don't think she minds if I say it, does she, okay? I also will tell you, her mother is very proud of you.
Hmm.
Okay. Her mother, is there a lot of tension there?
She's
her mother.
Yes. Well, okay. She's a strong, independent, voicey woman. Yeah,
she's not bashful expressing how she feels. Okay. But she does care. The next 4 months, when you start taking the Tai Chi, like I encourage you to, it also maybe get some more Reiki energy, not so much. You need different types of energy.
Work, yep.
Okay. Oh, I can't say that.
Yes, you can.
It said it's going to improve your sexual life, whatever that means. So that, everything you need that helps, okay? Nothing wrong with a back seat. I also will tell you, you're going to do a lot, you two are going to be doing a lot of travel. Do you like to travel? And I don't mean you're going around the world. I'm just saying, like, different weekend, take the dogs or have a big yard in the back. You have a big yard in the back. Because I can see you and your wife need to get away every once in a while.
I agree.
And I think you two need to build up your relationship. Not take.
Yeah, we haven't been able to do that in a while.
Okay. I'm going to tell you probably you should do it within the next month or a month and a half. I know you can. Does she work?
She does.
Okay. She's pretty exhausted, huh?
She's very exhausted. She's actually had to do a lot of overtime just to support the family.
You feel guilty.
I do.
Don't. You know, you get an income coming from, you get. I don't care where you get it from, but you get income coming in.
Finally. It was 6 months before. I had a 6-month window where the government wasn't paying me.
Oh, I know that. My roommate won a Social Security disability 6 years ago. We're still waiting for it.
Wow. Yeah.
They owe him over $300,000 right now.
They just
tried
to squeeze it right down to the last.
Yeah. Yeah, no, it was tight there for a little while.
But you've always been. Your wife is a survivor. She's not a quitter. Even though she complains and moans. But I wanted to let her know that whatever she does, she is going to be okay with. And I actually see her getting a big pay raise.
I'm okay with that, too.
What does she do?
She is a passport specialist. She processes passports.
Uh-huh. Oh, so she's going to be grading up to a higher grade level.
Outstanding.
Okay. She enjoys what she does, even though there are times when it could be boring.
Yes.
Okay. And I'm sure she gets a lot of people who don't deserve to have passports. You know what I'm saying?
I do.
I have a very good friend who lives in Vermont. She works for the Homeland Security. She's one of the executive chiefs of Homeland Security. Yeah. She said, you'd be amazed at what these people do to try to get in here and all that. Mm. And I'm not knocking everybody, you know. One thing, also looking, do you have a daughter?
I do.
Are you in contact with her?
Yeah, she lives at my house.
Oh, I guess you are. How old is she?
What did I say I was married? 28 years, she is 27.
Not married? But in a relationship?
Nope. She's an introvert.
Okay. Well, I actually see her finding a relationship that's going to be very good for her.
Outstanding.
Okay. And by the time she's 30, you're going to be a grandfather.
Outstanding even more.
And she's going to marry a guy who will be very blooming and very outgoing and very personal. But she's very happy hiding in the house.
Yes.
Okay. Does she work?
She does.
She works and then comes home?
Yep.
My scary part is when they can do everything on the computer, I would not want to see her on the computer as a job.
Right.
You know, bring it home, you know what I mean?
Right. Yeah, no.
And then she would become more introverted. And she has a beautiful heart.
She does.
She's also very intelligent.
She is, most certainly.
Was she made fun of in school?
Yes.
Okay. So that's the whole thing. They talk about guns. They talk about this and that. But they forget about the bullying. I was bullied.
Right.
You know?
Yep.
And they forget that has to be a reason why somebody's doing this. You know?
Right. Mm-hmm.
And, of course, I get everybody going on Facebook. Now I'm blocking it all out because that's not who I am. I know my own opinions. One other thing I also will tell you that I do see when your daughter starts growing out more, and there's a person, I don't know where she works at, but there's a gentleman that she's going to meet, and you're really going to like him.
Good.
The sad part is he has a lot of your similarities. I'm only kidding on that part.
That's even better.
Yeah. Well, that's like my granddaughter. She was going with this guy. And my son used to be in a band, mm-hmm. but the other guy was in the band, and she broke up. Now she wants to go with somebody else that was in the band. And it's like they all look at their fatherly image. By the way, I actually see you. Did you file a Class A lawsuit with your injuries?
I have not filed a suit. I am speaking to a lawyer.
Because I would encourage you soon that I don't want the time to expire.
Right.
Okay. Because I can see a Class A lawsuit with millions of dollars in your favor.
Okay.
You can handle that, right?
It wouldn't hurt my feelings. There'd be a whole lot of people that would benefit from it.
But there would be people, if you win that, you would want to kind of keep it incognito. Because you'd have friends coming out of the wall.
Yeah.
Oh, Eric, I'm your best friend, or I'm your, you know, and you
right.
don't really want to know that. When I'm talking about millions of dollars, I'm talking like 3 or 4 million.
Okay.
Okay. And the thing is, you have, of course, you know, your lawyer's going to get his share, but that's
right.
Okay. Okay. But no matter how much money you win, and I always tell people this, no matter how much money people win, the pain is still always going to be there.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And one thing is that please be very aware of your motorcycle. Once again, I don't want it to be your fault.
I agree with you.
Okay.
And I would not want it to be my fault either.
Because then they would turn around and sue you.
Yep.
Okay. And what I'm looking at as you're going down, you have a pretty windy road near where you live?
Yes.
Kind of narrow?
Yes.
Okay. And you got to be almost like, do you have a radio on your motorcycle?
I do.
Okay. It's going to be like you're listening, la, 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 dream, baby, dream, you know, type of song or whatever. And you're going to be nonchalant, not really paying that much attention. And all of a sudden, you're going to go through a stop sign when it's not really your time to go because another car is coming. So I want you to avoid that.
Right.
So you like tattoos, huh?
I do.
You got a few more coming.
Outstanding.
You have one on your back?
I do.
You got a full back?
No, more just up by the shoulder blades.
Can I see one coming down just below the shoulder, another one?
I have okay. been thinking about something like
I've
that.
I've also seen one here.
Ooh, I'm not so sure about that. You know,
I won't say where I see the other one because we're on the air. That's okay. Yeah. The problem with people is once they see people with tattoos, they automatically assume they're bad people.
Yeah, I think that's going away.
I have noticed that a lot.
Yeah,
because
yeah,
I walk into a room and people look at my. The first thing they look at is my tattoos, and they're like,
"I know a lot of employers will not hire people with
right.
a lot of tattoos."
That's still out there.
Yeah.
A little bit. Yeah.
My daughter-in-law just went and got 2 tattoos, one on each one of her feet. Yeah. Boy, is she in pain, but she's doing better now.
Yeah.
She loves tattoos. You know. Yeah. You have tattoos?
I have a couple. Yeah. Yep.
I have one over here with my ex-wife's name on it. 2 years later, we got divorced. Then I have a cross up here, and I have one here. I was in college when I had these put on. Woke up, oh my God, my arm was hurt. Then I saw why, you know. Material things don't mean that much to you, do they?
No.
I know that I went away. I do know there's a special ring that your wife wants that you're going to be getting for. The money will be there for you to get it. Okay. She has never come out. Material things don't mean a whole lot to her. As long as she's got the bills paid and enough food in the house. She wants better things, too. You have a nice, warm house.
Yes.
You and the bank own the house?
Yeah. Yeah, we share it.
You have to share it. But I also see you remodeling the inside.
I'm okay with that as well. We've been waiting to do that.
I see you remodeling the kitchen first.
Oh, I've so been wanting to remodel that kitchen.
I'm sorry?
I said I've so been wanting to remodel that kitchen.
I would encourage you to do that first.
Yeah.
Okay. And then you can. I know you can do it. It may take you longer because of the physical pain that you're going through. Mm-hmm. But I know that you can't tell him gay, can you? We're here for him like that, you know. But I know that you can do it.
I just made you expressive.
Yeah.
Is that what it is?
Thing.
Oh, okay,
yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, it's a good thing.
I also will know that your daughter's not overweight, right?
Not really.
No. She's very well developed. We'll put it that way.
She's got very strong Nordic blood.
There you go. And I, one of the things I'm also looking at her, too, and I do see her, when she surprised a person that she wants to be with, it's going to be amazing. She's going to lose some weight, and she's going to be more outward.
Beautiful.
And then you're going to say, oh, my God, where did my baby go?
You know? That might take a while, but I might take a vacation from that. But,
you're used to having it 24/7.
Yeah, yeah, we're pretty close.
Yeah, and that's amazing. I love it when I hear people. You're close with your child too.
Very
right?
Nice.
Yeah. Yeah.
And my son and I, we were estranged for a while, but the last 7 or 8 years we gotten closer together. Mm-hmm. I think he finally accepted the fact that I am who I am. Mm-hmm. Plus, I am a TV entertainer, and But when he doesn't like what I say, believe me, he's bashful. That's the way I like it, you know. And my granddaughter and I've always had a special relationship.
I think that's true of grandchildren.
I think
you get another chance.
Right.
For those.
How about Ted Ott, Paul? We got anything? Let me know you back here. You have been through hell and back.
What's
the last one? You got something we can find for 10 minutes? Like Ted Ott?
Let me see here. Keep talking and I'll check
it out. Okay. He does. You've been through hell and back the last 4 years, huh?
Yeah, I believe so.
Yeah, okay. But it's starting to get better.
It has been.
Okay. One thing I do see is your father's not well.
He's declining. I mean, he's...
How old is he?
83.
Okay, because I see dementia there. Thank you. I see some early forgetfulness.
Yeah, I
see
that.
But he recognizes you immediately. But then there's going to come a time when he's not going to. And he will say, oh, Eric was here today when it might be 2 or 3 days later, which is very normal for people of that type. But I also know that your relationship, there for a while, were kind of estranged, but you two had built up a very special bond. Keep sending out that olive branch to him and your mother. Okay. Mm-hmm. I would also tell you, when's the last time you and your dad went out somewhere, just the two of you?
20, 30 years ago?
How about you two going out to dinner or lunch? Just the two of you.
It's strange that you mention that because I was thinking about that just last week.
I would definitely encourage you. Boy, will that build up his character. Will that make him feel a lot better?
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? I believe in family unity so much, even though I don't know what it is except for my son. But I do have family reunion. Like my brother-in-law died, and I didn't. They told me the day of the funeral when I got to know it, but I didn't cry. I just didn't have any emotional feelings for it. I don't know what's wrong or right, but that's who I was. They didn't accept me, so I just said, okay.
Nope.
One of the things, if we close up here, I want to thank you for coming on, but don't give up on yourself. Please. I'll know. That's what I like about being a psychic. Because I can get a hold of her, and you'll get a hold of me, right? We'll get
I
on
will.
It.
I will.
Okay.
Yeah.
And I'll expect you to be a bottom if you don't behave.
Ooh. I was a sailor.
Oh yeah, this is what Lori does for me. I don't know if you're aware of this or not.
No, but tell me.
Oh yeah, you have to put these all in one uniform manner. See how
so
they're all mixed
like
up
that?
Yeah, like this. They all have to be
okay,
like that.
Got
okay.
That.
I'm very, Lori spoiled me.
I'll say Diego.
Yes, okay.
You know.
Sometimes being spoiled right? is okay.
I don't.
Yeah.
I don't like to label things like that. Oh.
You know, she spoils me. Terribly.
I call it neatness. That's what my mother taught me, right?
Yeah.
And I want to thank you both for coming on. Now, yesterday was Surge?
Surge, yep.
Surge,
yeah. Yep.
You want to tell the people what that is?
It's STIR stands for Seeking the Unknown Realm. We are a paranormal group out of this seacoast because Paula and I live in Maine, and most of the other half the group lives in Maine, half the group lives in New Hampshire. But we travel all over the seacoast, helping people out if they have some problems in their home. And you know, we don't charge for it. But I mean,
well, you're not allowed to, are you?
Some people do.
Some people do.
Some groups do.
But,
really?
Yep. Yeah, but it goes against our beliefs. I mean, you know, because some people, you know, they think that they have, you know, they hear something in the attic. Well, okay, so we're going to crawl up in the attic, and you may have a raccoon up there, you know.
Yeah. I watched this one lady, she had on the show here one time. She was doing the unknown here and all that. And she said, if you're right, you know, flash the red light, should nail you. Green light or whatever, you know, and I'm watching it. All of a sudden, she goes over there with numbers on the flashing back. I said, "Oh my God, she's getting contact!" Well, she didn't realize that she had the fan going. We caught her.
Right.
Yeah.
She had the fan going. Well, I want to thank you two for coming on. How was it as co-host?
It was fun.
Can we do it again?
Fun.
Are you?
Yeah, sure.
All
why
right.
not?
There you go. You want to come back on? Are you the chairman of the Surge?
No.
He was here the last
time. Yep, no. Yep. His name is Steve Clark.
That's right. Okay. Well, everybody, I want to thank you all. We're going to be turning these over to Paul in a very short. Welcome. Sorry nobody answered that question, but we're going to keep asking trivia questions.
I know. We can use it
okay?
next time.
And we can use that to have another one. Well, I want to thank you two for coming on.
Thank you for having me.
And, and your website?
I don't really have a website right now. I have an email address, and it's pclarkrm@comcast.net.
And then they want to find out about your
the Tai Chi or massage. I do teach Reiki and do Reiki, and also I'm a paranormal investigator, and I do the readings on the land and the property when I go.
Yeah, that's cool. You just go with certain. Do you have a website of your own? No.
I do not have a website of my own right now. But yeah,
we'll have you back on again.
I would love to be.
I reserved that right to do that.
Yes, you do.
Okay. But anyway, thank you all for listening. See you next week.